Glory to God in the highest. Almighty and our living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who loves and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
From the first book of Samuel. Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am. You called me." "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again, the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said. "You called me." But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am. You called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go asleep, and if you are called, reply, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord.
Oh, from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the body is not for immorality, but for the Lord. And the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord, and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that our bodies are members of Christ? But whoever is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Avoid immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body, but the immoral person sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been purchased at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
Two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord.
Allow me to start our reflection today with a simple pick-up line. Misteryo ka ba? Kasi ang hirap, ulit-ulit na tuwan, hindi pa rin kita lubos na maintindihan. Do you know some persons like that? If there are people like that, we should not be surprised, because there are really persons and things in this world that are hard to understand. They remain to be a mystery. But it does not mean that we should stop there. Rather, we should try to know and understand them better. In learning things, brothers and sisters, many times we do not get it the first time. Do you agree? In learning things, new things, we do not get it the first time. Having a new cell phone, many of us would not easily learn to use it the first time. Having new game applications, we would not know how to play them the first time. In learning how to cook well, we would not know how to cook well the first time. At school, students are told to learn by repetition, because they usually would not understand the lesson for the first time. Teachers have to repeat the lesson. And this is also true in preaching. This is also true, in the spreading of the gospel. True in the call for evangelization. Because the message is not understood and taken well the first time, or even the second time. So we priests, we have to repeat the message of our homilies, or we have to reintroduce the meaning of the gospel, because we cannot exhaust the mystery of the gospel of the Lord. And that must be the reason why we encounter similar and repeated sins in the life of Jesus, similar and repeated words and teachings in the Gospels. We have to see them and see them again and again. We have to encounter them again and again. We have to reflect on them again and again. Brothers and sisters, how many times have we heard or listened to the gospel reading of today? I'm sure many times we have listened already. So the words proclaimed by John today deserve to be repeated as we reflect on our theme of our Fiesta Senior 2018, Santo Niño, inspiration of renewed disciples for new evangelization. John proclaimed, "Behold the Lamb of God." Those words invite us again to consistently look at Jesus, to look at the Son to Him. Let us focus again
our attention to Him. Behold, the Lamb of God. Those words are asking us again to carefully study Jesus and get to know Him more. Those words
call us again to come and see. Brothers and sisters, this is what we should all be doing consistently for us to become renewed disciples of the Lord. To come and see again and again. The Son to Him would remain to be a mystery to us because we would not fully grasp why a God, our God, become or would become like us. And yet we have to continue learning from Him
because He is, and we believe,
that He is the way towards fullness and renewal. The two disciples took those words, "Behold the Lamb of God," to their heart upon hearing the message and upon seeing Jesus, and they followed Him. They did not fully understand the meaning of those words, and yet it was enough for them to follow Him. For sure there were questions in their minds, yet they proclaimed, "We have found the Messiah." Brothers and sisters, this kind of attitude is something that we should imitate for us to become true and renewed disciples of the Lord. It is fundamental for us to be attracted to and be captured by the person of Jesus, like a magnet of love. Patubalay sa Roma. Allow me to repeat that. It has to be fundamental for us, followers of the Lord, to be attracted to and be captured by the person of Jesus, like a magnet of love, over and over again. And so, are we attracted to Him? Are we all captured by His love? Look around us. What do we see? Our being gathered together here, brothers and sisters, testifies that we are attracted to and captured by Jesus. We are captured by His love. Naalala ko tuloy yung kwento ng kaibigan ko. Isang araw, sinabi niya sa girlfriend niya, "Alam mo, or alam mo ba, ang pagmamahal mo ay parang posas?" Sabi niya, girlfriend niya,
"Bakit naman?" Sagot niya,
"Kasi wala akong kawala. Wala akong kawala."
If you think about it, brothers and sisters, that is who Jesus is to us.
That is how His love is for us. Wala tayong kawala sa Kanya. Walang-wala tayong kawala sa pagmamahal ni Jesus. Though He remained to be a mystery, yet He told those disciples, He gathered them and captured them by His love. And that was the kind of experience the disciples had when they encountered Jesus. They were captured by His person, by His love. To become renewed disciples then means we have to continue looking forward to encounter Jesus, to reflect on His life, to reflect on His words and His teachings. It means we have to be attracted to and be captured by Him over and over again. And this is something that we have to seriously commit to.
We have to do this because to follow Him implies a level of commitment that involves deeper reflection in the means of struggles and sacrifices. Jesus asked the two followers of John, "What are you looking for?" It was a kind of gesture, a kind gesture of inspiration to self-examination.
Jesus was actually saying or asking, what do you really want from me? Do you really understand what you are about to do? This tells us that becoming true and renewed disciples involves a task, a great task, a difficult task. It means to stay with Jesus, and to stay with Jesus is not easy. It means to spread the message of Jesus to the world, and it is a difficult task. Brothers and sisters, this is what the challenge of the new evangelization means. We do not grow in the knowledge of the mystery of the person of Jesus. We are not driven and captured by His love and become renewed disciples only for ourselves. We become true and renewed disciples for us to reach out to people and bring the message of Jesus to them. The word to spread the gospel is not only given to priests, to religious, and ministers. It is given to all of us, to all Christians. It is the mission of every renewed disciple of the Lord.
Brothers and sisters, having received the gospel ourselves, having looked at the Santo Niño again and again, let us realize that our hearts yearn to share our experiences of God to and with others. It is not a secret to keep, but it is a message to proclaim. May we all continue to grow in the understanding of the mystery of Jesus, the Santo Niño, and be sustained by His love. Amen. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages,
God, light from light,
true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father.
For him all things were made.
For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnated of the Virgin Mary and became man.
For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. And His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who in the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord Jesus is kind and merciful, and He answers all our prayers in the way that is best for us. Let us now give up to sing our Santo Niño de Cebu all our prayer intentions for this Novena Mass. Let us sing. Señor Santo Niño, may Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and deacons be filled with joy and strength when they feel that they are not short in faith, in moral ascendancy, and even in basic necessities. We pray.
May civil and political leaders discern what is truly beneficial for our people, and may they be given the determination to do it.
we pray.
Senhor Santorio, receive our petition.
May the poor, the sick, the jobless, and the marginalized experience liberation and support from their communities and loved ones. We pray.
Senhor Santorio, receive our petition.
May married couples and those preparing for marriage draw from you the wisdom, patience, and strength necessary to make your marriage a reflection of your love and joy for your people. We pray.
Senhor Santorio, receive our petition.
May those who are discerning to enter religious life be led closer to Jesus and have willingness to detach themselves from worldly things. We pray.
Senhor Santorio, receive our petition.
We lift up to the Lord all the intentions and prayers offered and the souls prayed for by the pilgrims and devotees of Senhor Santorio. Let us pray to the Lord.
Senhor Santorio, receive our petition.
We pray for peace in our country and in the whole world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Senhor Santorio, receive our petition.
Heavenly Father,
you call us to participate in the life of your Son.
In this Eucharist, fill us with the joy of your salvation. Give us courage and strength to witness to your love and protection during these difficult times.
Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
participating virtually in this festivities. For whenever the memorial of his sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, true Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness of his hearts, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. With the passion of the cross, he freed us from an ending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and demons, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, the supper was ended, with the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. it may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the faithful.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, may all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, to be married, to be co-heirs, to eternal life, and be praised and glorified through your Son, Jesus the Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Thank you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who go to the supper of the Lamb.
Bye, Sadala.
Sa
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and your kindness make those you have nourished with his one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prayer to St. Antonino.
O my dear Jesus, you are our King, you are our God. Because of your love for us, you came down from heaven, born of the Virgin Mary. My heart beats for the sight of your goodness. You have committed many sins. Forgive us, O Jesus,
for our sin and gratitude, and return for your goodness.
Strengthen our will to resist temptation and sin. In your grace, we will be able to fulfill our promises and share in your glory in heaven. O Holy Child Jesus, who is ever good and loving, we kneel before you, our true God. With humility, we implore you to give us your mercy and grant us all the favors we ask of you in this Medina. So that we will enjoy the blessings of heaven. Amen.
Fourth day of Easter.
O merciful Jesus, you have forgiven those who crucified you. We implore you to give us a forgiving heart, so that we may always pardon those who will hurt us in word and in deed. It is we ask in your holy name. Amen.
In the silence of our hearts, let us ask Senor Santonino to hear our prayers and grant our petitions in this Eucharistic celebration.
Let us pray. O sweet merciful Jesus, Senor Santonino, the source of all goodness, kneel before your sacred image, implore your divine aid for universal peace and brotherhood among all men and women. Guide them and believers and the heathens, so that they will believe you as their true God. Restore pain for those who have wandered away from you. Lead them back to your home with repentance in their hearts. Grant those of the people departed in your glory the remission of all their sins, so that they will rest in peace forever. I believe, nourish, and strengthen our faith in you, so that we will serve you faithfully on earth. Amen.
Kalihok, maglipon, tanay kalipuran. Sa dilit pa ang katapusan ng panalangin, aduna kita'y mga kaibalo o pasalamat. Una, kalihok, nung tinaroon na ito ang kalipyo sa Basilica Pilgrim Center o sa palibot ngini sa tanang higayon. Ikadua, sa pagpanggawas niya, inahinay o magpasisyahay lang ugway ikunuray. Ikatulo, pagbantay-bantay sa inyong mga bag o pitaka aron dili kini mahikalimtan. Ug ning bahina sa ngalan sa tanang kaparian Agustino dili sa Basilica Minore del Santo Niño de Cebu, pinasingkasing o painito na itong pasalamatan ang tanang nakatampo sa kalampusan sa atong alasiko imedya ng Misa Novena ni Itaupat na Adlaw sa Luminaryo sa Kapistahan sa atong mahal na Senyor Santo Niño. Ngadto sa mga Mass of Children Sponsors, Praying Communities, Glories of the Day, Choir, Tanang Volunteers, o tanang mga deboto sa Senyor Santo Niño ng Itambong Karon. Sa kanila, o tanatong tanan, masipang pakpak o pasalamat. Sa hantayan ng usap nato, ang kapaloy ni konsilibrar ni Inisa Karon. Ato silang tagaan sa masipang pakpak o pasalamat. Sa atong Mass Presider of Holiness, ang Vice Rector din sa Basilica Minore del Santo Niño de Cebu, si Ras Reverend Father Dante Bolo OSA. Dahil natin pakpak ang mga. At napaw sa tanan, nato sa atong ipasdunggan ni nato ang selebrasyon karon. Ang Batang Jesus ni Señor Santo Niño. Ako si Anday Gon sa pinakamasitang Viva el Señor!
Viva el Señor!
Viva Señor Santo Niño!
Viva Señor Santo Niño!
Viva el Señor!
Viva el Señor!
Ay, masipagpak!
The sin of these articles are held is in the name of the Lord. God, by His word, all things are made holy, pour out your blessing on these religious articles and symbols of faith and devotion. Grant that anyone who uses them in accordance with your will and your law, and with a spirit of thanksgiving, may experience by your power, health in body, and protection in soul. As they invoke your most holy name, through Christ, our Lord. The Lord be with you.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Mass has ended. Go, all you may, the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Viva, good Señor!
Viva!